only feels like yesterday I was back on my home planet. But I'm far from it. Arrived on Earth on the 17th of November 2010. My mission is to study human life forms, their appearance, their habits, their strengths, their weaknesses, and every single possible thing I can understand about them. I arrived here 5 years ago, and it's been the worst 5 years of my entire life. When these humans only live to an average age of 96, my race lived to an average age of 462. I suppose 5 years isn't too bad, but I'm done. Finished. I feel as if I am done with this mission, and well, to be honest, I'm simply sick of being here. As soon as I arrived here, I rented this house out. I work at a supermarket. I earn an average amount of money to be able to live in a house like this. I have to appear as a human and as normal as possible, so that not a single one of these disgusting humans can suspect a thing. So, I shop, clean, socialise, laugh, cry, eat, sleep, hug, travel, cook, vacuum, watch movies, listen to music, and do so many more boring and pointless things with this life that will get me nowhere, just like the humans do. So, I must appear human, but at the same time, analyse and study these confusing beings. This is my mission. And this is my final year, and it's possibly the happiest I've been in a while. But I must not dwell on being happy, since that is a human emotion that I should be pretending and shouldn't be feeling. Shower, do my hair, do my makeup, and make myself look presentable for the humans. I then eat breakfast and watch TV. The day I got here, I quickly learned that people like and are more accepting of nice people. People that laugh at your shit jokes, make conversation, help the elderly, pretend they're happy with their terrible lives. So I choose to be a nice girl, a good girl, and most of all, a respectable girl. So respectable that no one could suspect a thing out of such a good girl like me.
I'm so sorry to bother you, but can you tell me how to get to the city?
Oh, well, you just look down this street here.
Not a very nice street, is it?
No, no, they really are.
Have you lived here long?
Only a few years. How about you? I mean, you look about 30.
Oh, Lord, no, darling, you're very kind. What's your name?
Abby. I'm really sorry, but I'm in a bit of a hurry to work.
No worries. Okay, so I'll just take that road back there.
Yep, and you make a left on Maple Street. You keep going down and you should hit the city.
Oh, great. No worries. Thank you for that. Anyway, I'm sorry to hold you up.
Yeah, that's all right. Anytime.
No worries. I will see you later, Abby.
Okay, see ya.
No worries. Thanks.
Bye.
My God, that was hell. Why was she showing so much affection towards someone she just met? I hate helping the humans, especially like that. Don't understand. Millions of dollars are spent on advertising cars as dangerous pieces of machinery and to always wear your seatbelt, when all that money is practically washed down the drain. And it's $2.50 for a ticket every single admission simply to ride a death trap. Ugh.
So tonight I've invited my best friend, Mary, over. I'm forced to hug her and greet her.
Sit down with her and listen to her boy troubles. Talk about boys, talk about her work, talk about my work, talk like we haven't seen each other in 7 years, even though we saw each other 7 days ago. Talk about Mary's boy troubles, talk about shopping, talk about Mary's boyfriend, again. Talk about her hair, talk about my hair, bitch about her friends, bitch about my friend. Talk about school, talk about Mary's boyfriend. Oh, and did I mention we talk about Mary's boyfriend? Oh, I didn't? Well, we talk about Mary's boyfriend a lot.
Bye.
A particular thing I hate about the humans is how much time they waste. Humans waste so much time on pointless things. So much time that could be spent accomplishing something. Almost every precious moment of their lives is wasted. Everything. Sleeping, eating, laying down, laughing, standing, going to the park, walking, sleeping, talking on the phone, standing, sleeping, laughing, sleeping, walking, and so many other pointless things. So this is it. Tomorrow, I go home. Tomorrow, I leave this planet. This is my final entry, my final evaluation. So what do I think of the humans? Well, when I first got here, I realised that the humans are hardly even human. Sure, they look human, sometimes even act human, but none of them are who they really are. Everything they do is an added sedative to making a perfect projection of themselves. That's all they do. Every action they make is fake. Everything. They shine their shoes and style their hair, do their makeup, laugh at their jokes. They light their lights, drink their drinks, eat their shitty food, act cool, act sad, act happy. It's all an act. They put on their lipstick, apply their mascara, do their ties, laugh, cry, sleep, spray their perfume, put on their rings and blink, find things to buy, get some money, spend some money, waste some money, and then spend some more. All to buy clothes they don't need to fit in with people they don't need. But I'm not a monster. I'm just the only person on this planet that can admit the truth. What I've learned from this mission is that it's meant nothing. This journal, this entry, everything. It's meant nothing. Thank you.
Abby? Abby?
Instructed to wait and be brought back up to my home planet.
Doesn't even like you.
Mary, I'll give you 5 seconds to run.
What?
2. 3.
You know what? Stop treating me like a child. You're the one being a backstabbing bitch.
4.
How's everything been?
Fine.
Have you seen Mary lately?
Yeah. She went on a holiday trip or something. I'm sick of it.
Sick of what?
Sick of life.
What about?
Why am I here?
What?
Why am I here? Why am I here?
I don't know.
You know why?
Be quiet!
Turn around with your hands up. Stand up.
Life, this imitation, this lie, has meant nothing.